Well, hello everybody, it's Lady G, and I just wanted to come to you today, Sunday, with Sing Your Song Sunday. You know, I was watching some protests, and I saw a young man, looked to be about 15 years old, and this young man had a bullhorn and a fist, that's all he had. And he was walking through the town, and he was singing his song, and he was singing A Change Is Gonna Come by Sam Cooke. That really touched my heart. As that young man sung that song, he was just looping and looping. When he finished, he would just start over and over. And all he had was a bullhorn and a fist. But I'm gonna tell you, it moved the people. He had a crowd walking behind him, but as he walked by other people, some of the other people began to join into the protest and join into the march. And all they did was held their arms up and they protested to A Change Is Gonna Come. That made me think how a song can change the mentality, the mindset, and the moment. It can also change the mood. I thought about some situations in the book where the mood was changed with music. The first incident I thought about was King Saul. How King Saul was troubled with evil spirits. They were coming and troubling him. So he would call in little David to play on the harp, and David would play on the harp until he would soothe him and he would go on to sleep. I thought about another man in the book. His name was Jehoshaphat. He was a mighty warrior. He was a captain of a mass army, and the enemy had encamped round about him. The enemy had gotten more enemies, and they had became allies, and they had encamped him round about. But Jehoshaphat, he went to the Most High, and he began to pray and say, what should we do? Should we fight him? What should we do? And the Most High said, just praise me, just sing and worship me and praise me. So Jehoshaphat did just that. He called his army in. He told them what his instructions were. They began to worship the Most High and praise, honey. The enemy got so confused, they started killing themselves off, and it took Jehoshaphat them 3 whole days to go in and collect all the goods from them bodies. I'm telling you. And when they got back to the camp, guess what they did? They sung again. And then I'm thinking about a story. This one is not in the book. This is like a nursery rhyme, fairy tale or something. But this individual was called the Pied Piper. Yes, he was. And the Pied Piper was a smart little, let me tell you what he did. There was a town that had an infestation of rats. The rats would come in, they would eat up the cheese, they would bite the babies, they was just causing all kind of trouble. So they had a town hall meeting. And in the town hall meeting, the mayor, they were all meeting, trying to figure out, what can we do about this problem? Well, so what happened was, the Pied Piper knocks on the door. They go and open the door. He comes in. He said, I can help you. I can solve this problem. They were so excited because they wanted to get rid of them rats. So the Pied Piper named his price. They agreed. The mayor agreed to pay the price, and all the townsmen, they agreed. Okay, yeah, we'll pay him. So the Pied Piper went to the middle of the street. He took out his pipe. He started to play his little tune on his pipe. And lo and behold, all the rats began to come out, and they began to follow the Pied Piper. So he marched down the middle of the street playing that little tune, and all the rats just followed him. They followed him right into the river, and they drowned. So now the Pied Piper had gotten rid of all the rats. There were no rats. They went and sealed up all the holes, and they still had a big old party. So the Pied Piper was sitting back waiting for the party to be over. So after the party was over, he went back to the mayor and said, okay, it's time for you to pay me up. The mayor was like, well, I don't think we're going to pay you as much as we said. We're going to pay you a little bit, but not as much as we agreed. The Pied Piper was like, you said you was going to pay me X amount of dollars. The mayor was like, well, take it or leave it, because once the rat's dead, you can't bring them back, so take it or leave it. The Pied Piper, he was furious. He was very upset. So, honey, he went into the middle of the street. He got his pipe out, and they was like, well, play to your heart's content, honey, because we got rid of the rats. I don't know what you're doing. The Pied Piper began to play on his little pipe, honey, and as he began to play, guess what happened? The little children started dropping their toys and started following him. The more he played, the more they followed him. The mothers came out. The fathers came out. They was devastated. They was heartbroken. They was trying to figure out what is going on. The children was following the Pied Piper. They got to a big old mountain, and when they got to the mountain, the mothers sighed a sigh of relief. They said, oh, my baby can't climb that mountain, but the Pied Piper kept playing his music, and as he played the music, a door opened in the mountain. The children went into the mountain, the door shut, and them parents never seen their babies again. Now, I know that's kind of a sad story, but I wanted to let you know the impact that music have on an individual. Today is Sing Your Song Sunday. It does not matter. Music will put you into a frame of mind that nothing else can. Now, it's important to choose your music very wisely, because music, you can sing a lie just as well as you can tell a lie. And you don't want to be walking around here singing no lies, and a lot of these people singing under folks' clothes and singing all kind of stuff and hateful stuff. Don't do that. But sing you some music that's going to uplift you, that's going to upbuild you, that's going to make you feel good about yourself. Get you a song. And if you're around people that don't want to hear you sing your song, honey, get you an iPad, get you some earphones, Get you some earpiece to put in your ear, some earphones. Put in your ear, listen to your music, because music has a way of changing the whole tone, changing the whole atmosphere. That's why people say praises will confuse the devil, because the way Jehoshaphat, when they started praising and praying, honey, them devils got crazy and they started killing themselves. So I want to encourage you today. Today is Sing Your Song Sunday. Don't you worry about what nobody say. Don't worry about how they talk about you. Sing your song. Sing a song that's going to uplift you, going to encourage you. Go in the book of songs. It ain't nothing but full of a bunch of songs. You can pick a song, a phrase out of there, and make up your own song. Don't worry about people. People might have told you, you just like a homeowner that's locked out. You have no key. They probably told you that you can't carry a tune in a bucket. Don't worry about it, honey. When I get in the shower, honey, turn on the music, that is my symphony, honey. That's my band. That's my pianist. That's my organs. That water, honey, just sing to your heart's content. But today is Sing Your Song Sunday. Honey, sing your song. I'm going to try to sing a little bit of this song. Now, don't y'all judge me now, but I'm just going to sing a little bit on it, because today is Sing Your Song Sunday, okay? So there's a scripture in Psalms, and I'm just going to sing a little bit of it to show you how you can just make up your own song. Don't worry about it, but Sing Your Song Sunday, okay? Now, this is what I'm going to do. So you do you, and I'm going to do me. But sing your song, honey. Don't let nobody tell you to stop singing. I think it was Maya Angelou said, now I know why the caged bird sing. Song set a tone. So be careful what you allow to enter your ears, because what goes into your ears goes into your mind, goes into your heart. So you don't want to just plant any old seeds. You want to plant good stuff. I want to tell you about another songstress. Her name was Beyonce. Everybody know Beyonce. She was singing this song, To the Left, To the Left. And in that song, she had some lyrics in there that said, I can get another you in a minute. And a lot of women kick their husbands and whatever to the left, and they still waiting on that another you in a minute, because everybody can't get another one in a minute, and somebody's still waiting on that another one to come by. So you got to be careful what you allow in your ear gate, in your eye gate. So anyway, I'm trying to think of this song that I was singing. Here we go. I will sing praises, oh Lord, you are my strength. I can't even remember the song, y'all. Let me see if I can sing this song. And I was you, oh Lord, my strength. To thee, oh Lord, my strength. I will sing unto thee, oh Lord, my strength. Unto thee, oh Lord, my strength. Unto thee, oh Lord, my strength. I will sing unto thee, O Lord, my strength. Unto thee, O Lord, my strength. Unto thee, O Lord, my strength. I will dance, for you are my strength. You can make your own song up. It don't even take much for you to make up a song. Just make up a song. Sometimes if you're feeling down in the depth, you don't have to sing no blues song. Now, I remember my mama used to sing blues. They used to have parties at the house, and they loved the blues. And I just couldn't understand across 110th Street, cheating in the next room. I could not understand that. Honey, when things is not going my way and look like trouble is all around me, honey, I like to get a song like, I command you, Satan, in the name of the Lord, to take up your weapons and flee, for the Lord has given me authority to walk all over thee. And sometimes when I feel like I'm just in a rut and I ain't going nowhere and look like things is not turning around for me, I find a song. I pull a song out of the air, honey, and I'll be saying, I can travel now, got on my traveling. I can travel now, got on my traveling shoe. I can travel now, got on my traveling shoes. So it don't matter what kind of song you sing, long as it's upbeat, it's uplifting, it brings you joy. That young man really touched my heart, because he was singing, a change is going to come. And honey, if you get you a song and you sing your song, sing yourself happy, honey. Sing yourself into a better frame of mind, because something about music will put you in a frame of mind. It will put you in a happy place. So I just wanted to come to y'all today and say Sunday is Sing Your Song Sunday. And you might start, I left that little error in there. I didn't edit it out because I wanted y'all to see. Sometimes you mess up when you're singing your song. Sometimes it don't come out the way you want to. So you singing to yourself. You have an audience of one, you and the Most High. So don't worry if people don't like your voice and they feel like you can't sing. Honey, sing anyway. This is Sing Your Song Sunday. So I challenge each and every one of you to get your favorite song that uplifts you, that gives you joy and make you jump up and go, hey, that's my jam. Y'all remember Witness when she was saying, I want to dance with somebody? get you a song that's going to change your mindset. Don't be talking about gloom and doom and I've been down nobody. Don't sing them songs, but sing them songs that's going to uplift you and make you feel good about yourself. So today is Sing Your Song Sunday. All right, y'all. This is Lady G with Sing Your Song Sunday. Y'all better sing now. Sing.